Hello everyone, welcome you all for this episode of Startup Story series. In our Startup Story series, we have a lot of entrepreneurs coming over here and sharing their successful entrepreneur journey so that you all can learn from their journey, what you should take and what you should avoid, what mistakes you should avoid. This is what we are learning every single episode. And to share this entrepreneurial journey with us today, we have a special person, one of my good friends, Kedar Bol, with us today. So welcome Kedar Bol for the show.
Thank you. Thank you, Guna. It's a pleasure to come over to this show and welcome to all of you. This is Kedar Bole here. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah. And to give a quick background about Kedar Bole, by profession he's an engineer and he completed PG in construction and management. After working for more than 10 years in the construction and interior industry, he started his first business. He became an entrepreneur as a contractor and then he went on to become a project management consultant, and then he found his passion of training and coaching and he started training business, and so far he has trained more than 10,000 people in many cities in India, and he is also called the marketing expert, and he's actually giving a lot of people idea and awareness on what kind of marketing habits any business should have. So he's going to share with us what is his journey. And from his journey, he's going to share the mistakes, the challenges, how it all happened and what all he crossed, what kind of obstacles he had. This is what we're going to hear from him. And we can definitely have a lot of takeaways from Kedar's journey. So let's go to the show now. Kedar, welcome again to the show.
Thank you.
And first question is that what we want to ask is, like, it is more of construction, interior, and that's how it is. And then you entered into training business. So before I ask that, why you entered into the training and coaching business, I want to know what made you, or what incident made you to start your own business as a contractor when you were working for more than 10 years in this industry? What suddenly happened and why you started your own business? What happened?
Okay, wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. So firstly, I would love to thank everyone who's watching this right now, because this is something, you know, if you are able to learn, that means you will be growing on a regular basis. And Guna, you are doing a fantastic job of, teaching people something that they can take away. And why should you reinvent the wheel when Guna is there? Guna is teaching you exactly those things to, start up. So thank you so much, Guna, for inviting me on this show. At this moment, I would love to tell you, I particularly remember this was way back in 2010, when I was working with the Hinduja Group, and I was in my cabin. I was preparing comparative quotations for one of the companies. I picked up those comparative quotations. I walked around the floor and I went into my boss's cabin and I just knocked the cabin door and he said, yeah, come in. And I went into the room. He was sitting, looking at completely a different direction, and there was sunlight, the blinds were at an angle. The sunlight was just crossing across to him and he was sitting like a Zen master. And when I went inside, I said, sir, he said, yeah, sit down. And I just sat, and then he was still in his that gaze. He turned around and he looked at this, the comparatives, and he's like, Kedar, what's your opinion out of these? I said, sir, I think this guy has been given as the best one. And I told him all of that. I'm like, okay, you think so? We should do it. He said, yeah, go ahead. And then I was about to leave and he's like, Kedar, I have a question for you. I said, yeah, sir, go ahead. He said, what's your age? I was like, what kind of a question is this? I mean, I said 29 odd. I think I was 29. Or he's like, okay, Kedar, what do you think after 10 years you would be doing? I was like, this is not an interview. I know sir for almost more than two and a half years now. I said, sir, maybe in your seat or maybe in some company where I'll be like something at par with what you're doing. Because he was 10 years elder to me. It's like, yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. But is that what you want to do all the time? I mean, we'll be doing just this thing, these quotations, this construction, everything. We'll be just doing this. And I was like, and he's like, hey, don't worry. I have just certain thoughts in my mind. And then he turned around and he said, yeah, thanks. I picked up that and I started walking back to my cabin, like my seat. And, there were suddenly these wheels which were moving in my head. I was like, what is happening? What am I doing? Do I really want to be in this position 10 years down the line? And there were these questions that started jumping in my head. And that, you know, gentleman, Mr. Vivek Keskar, I really thank him that he started, you know, these wheels in motion for me. So particularly, and then, you know, luck, had it, or I would say, you know, there was this guy who's my contractor, who was contracting, and he had a labor force of 500 people. And he approached me saying, Kedar, sir, aap baat achha karte ho. I mean, that was his in Hindi, he was saying, you're able to talk well and all of that. And aap client la sakte ho. When you speak, people will come and work with us. So you become my partner. You know, and I am thinking something like this, you know, within a couple of months, there is this something that happens to me. And honestly, I was like, this is amazing. I mean, I always felt, you know, the people who are entrepreneurs, no, these guys are their own boss. There's nobody to ask them. Whenever they want to come, they can come. And all of that, I was looking and then this guy's asking me to be a partner. And I just didn't think anything. And I just jumped. I told my company, sir, I think I want to, you know, I want to move over. I want to do this. The company was amazing. The company told me, okay, you can start your own business, but you complete this project. You come for 2 days to work, 3 days to work, 2 hours to work. We don't care. You have to complete this hospital project which you're doing and you simultaneously start your business. So I am really thankful to the Hinduja Group for allowing me to do something like this. That was amazing of them. And simultaneously, I started doing this. Eventually, I completed the project. I got into this entrepreneurial journey. And when I got into this contracting business, I got a lot of business. I got a lot of business for the company. But almost 1.5 years down the line, I realized this partner of mine is looking here and I am looking here. We had two complete different perspectives of life, you know, relationships, of money, of everything. And that's when I realized, oh my God, what am I doing? I mean, over such a long period of time, there was one big realization. What am I doing? Other thing, I have no incoming. It's all outgoing. There is all the bank balance that I had earned out in the past 10 years is completely wiped off. And I have not done any, nothing is in writing. So I have no stake. I have nothing now. And that was a big realization. So this was my start to my entrepreneurial journey. You asked me, how did I start? This is how I started.
Okay, so Kedar, since you said one mistake that me and my partner was completely in a different direction in every aspect of life. Now, can you just tell what were the few mistakes you did in that first business, which actually made you to realize a lot of things which you should carry forward for the next businesses when you have to start?
Absolutely. So if you're entering a partnership, one thing which I would say is get everything documented, get everything written down. And that's exactly what I did when I, after that, almost that was way back in 2011. So I think after 4 years, I entered into my next official partnership. And in that partnership, we had absolutely everything on paper. So we had so much of details on paper because of my previous experience. We hired a lawyer. We were ready to pay the fees. So, you know, if you hire consultants, if you hire people, it's the best, because don't go to somebody, oh, he's giving me something at less. Chalo, you know, I might save. You know, it is definitely something which I see, you know, it's penny wise and pound foolish. So rather than hire a consultant who can draft these documents very well, and the agreement that we got drafted for our partnership had all the clauses mentioned and all the eventualities also, in case if one of us decides to move out, in case we both mutually decide to dissolve or whatever that happens, in case, you know, what is the succession? Can we carry the brand name? Or every little nitty gritty details we penned it down. And that's when I went into that partnership. Well, that partnership holds so strongly on paper very well, because, you know, we exactly know, and due to which now this partnership, when we decided to create two different verticals, we are very clear on these two verticals. How do we create those verticals? So my partner now looks after the Success Habits Academy online vertical. I look after the Success Habits Academy offline vertical. So it is because of this stringent, you know, paperwork which we got into place right at the entry point. I think if you're getting into a partnership, paperwork, extremely important. I mean, you trust people, you know, in that flow, in that energy. We do a lot of things. I mean, I was like excited to get projects, and I was getting projects. I mean, getting projects. See, marketing is something which comes to me naturally. So I was able to, you know, present the company well. I was able to talk to people. People used to get connected, convinced. Something that I realized that I was not looking at the numbers. The numbers after that. So I was only looking at getting projects. So almost within a year's time, I had got projects, what, crossing close to 8 crores. 8 crores worth of interior design projects is a huge number. So, you know,
that 2011, it's not now, it is in 2011.
It's in 2011, 8 crores worth of projects I was able to, you know, get through. Well, I have nothing against my partner also, because he had his own views. I mean, it is his thought process and it is my thought process. It's just that I never checked, you know, I was just excited that, you know, I'll be an entrepreneur, I'll be my own boss. And, you know, there is nobody to ask me. But that is when I realized it's actually a challenge when there is nobody to ask you. There is nobody to hold you accountable. You are accountable for yourself, and it's a different ball game. And now when I teach and coach people, accountability is one thing which I strongly urge entrepreneurs that find an accountability partner, because that will make a big difference. So yeah, so that's what happened, my learning from the partnership failures.
Okay, so now just you started that, you just said you coach entrepreneurs in such a way. What made you to come into this training and coaching business, and why do you think anybody need a coach when it's when somebody who's starting a business or who's already doing business or who wants to take care of their health or who wants to have a good relationship in any aspect? Coach is something very phenomenal right now, and it has become a very, very, very most unavoidable thing in life so that you can get benefits. But according to you, why do you think coach is important? And also, you also tell me before that, you tell me why you moved into this particular business altogether from a different industry, because training and construction have nothing to do with it, right? So what made you to come into this industry?
Well, actually, a lot of people keep asking me exactly this same question. So I'll just rewind back to 2011. After I split from my partner, I started my own company where I started doing interior contracting business. Getting these contracts for interior design, interior contracting projects, I joined an organization called as BNI. Where I used to get a lot of referrals from this. This is a networking organization. So I was a member of it, and due to which I started getting a lot of business. And in that organization, I met another a partner of mine, whom I tied up for the interior design works. And that is where I realized, yes, my forte is contracting and project management, and her forte was into designing. And that is where, you know, the synergy worked superbly. And that synergy worked so brilliantly that we started growing our business, you know, from leaps and bounds. But during that course, how to grow our business, we were kind of, you know, we were doing whatever, you know, that we understood on our way. We were doing a lot of trial and error. But at that moment, we saw this organization called, which was, you know, actually delivering trainings to entrepreneurs. Where we saw, okay, there is something. I met this amazing guy there who was training people how to take their business to the next level. And his name was Sudhir Kolam. So I met him and I started taking training from him how to grow my business. So this was way back in 2014. So 2014, I started to now take the business to the next level. The business started growing because we were now focused on to, you know, what kind of projects we need to do. And at that moment, when we started, you know, getting focused on what projects we do, certain projects, we started targeting the right customers. And when the right customers came in, we got projects which were, you know, way bigger than we had ever imagined, because we put everything on paper and all of that happened. And there were projects which then started getting published in magazines. I mean, that is the level of projects that we started getting. This was going good at that time. But at the same time, obviously, I was doing this contracting and project management, which was something which was, I was not, you know, I honestly, today, when I see back, I was doing it. But maybe, you know, I was just doing it so that, you know, I am able to sustain my lifestyle. And the projects, when I used to get them completed, I used to have a high. But the part which I used to love there was project management. The contracting part is something where, you know, in one of my discussions with my partner, she actually pointed out to this to me, that Kedar, this word contractor, you know, you're not comfortable at being called as a contractor. I have nothing against contractors. But somewhere, you know, it was... I was not able to get myself in sync with what I was doing, but I had no idea. I mean, this now I can say, you know, I can connect. And then there was a BNI happened to me. So in BNI, they gave me to do trainings. And I was particularly remember clearly this training, which I was doing way back during 2015 end. And I was doing this training in front of a audience of 150. At Mithila Banquet Hall, which is in Juhu. And exactly after the training ended, in the second row, there was this guy sitting who stood up and he started walking towards me with a nice smile on his face. And he's telling me, you know what, Kedar, I have been watching you do trainings for the past 1 or 2 years in BNI. And your trainings are good. I said, okay, thank you. I was almost expecting him to say something like that. But then he said, I would love to tell you something. I said, yeah, go ahead. You know what, Kedar? Trainings is like meditation to you. And I was like, what are you saying? Trainings is like meditation? He said, yeah, I have seen you train. And when you meditate, you are in a higher state of yourself. I said, yeah. So that's exactly what happens when you are on that stage. And it just hit me like anything. I was like, exactly. This is the state in which I want to be all the time. I mean, I want to be here. And trust me, Guna, at that moment, I decided that I want to be a trainer. I want to help people. And this is what I want to do. It was not easy because at that moment, I was doing contracting and project management already. You know, there was a lot of money which was there in the market. Unless I don't pay off that, the contractors will not allow me to go back to trainings and coachings. And the only thing I knew at that moment that I need to sell my house. If I'm ready to sell my house, the money I'll get, the house in which I was staying, okay? So I decided to get into this trainings and coaching by selling my house off. And I put my house on sale. I got the token for my home. And my wife and my dad, I really thank them. You know, every time they joined me into this madness. They agreed that we will sell our only house in which we are staying. And we will go on a rental house to, you know, fulfill my passion. Because they also believed that this is something that I'm made for. And I got the token, and this is where I firmly believe if you really want something, you know, the universe conspires. And on my wife's birthday on 2016, 8th of November, I got a wonderful gift. And this gift was given to me by none other than a gentleman who stood up on my wife's birthday on 8th of November at 8 p.m. He stood up and he said, Mitra, you remember what he said? 8th of November?
Yeah, I remember.
He said demonetization.
Currency, yeah.
Yeah. He said demonetization. And I mean, that turned the tables for me. You know, I got calls from my clients who never used to take my calls saying, Kedar, where are you? I said, sir, I'm at home. Hey, come down. I've got 4 lakhs for you. I mean, I got my money crazily from the market.
You just recovered all the outstanding funds during one week.
Crazy. Absolutely. This guy also called me saying, Kedar, I don't think I can buy your house. I said, I don't even want to sell it now. I have got the money back from the market. I don't want to sell it. In fact, today that the house that which I had is actually earning me a passive income. So things have changed drastically, dramatically. But this is where I believe, you know, if you really want something and if you are ready to follow it like anything, you know, do whatever it takes. The moment you say, I am ready to do whatever it takes, the universe is there with you because it is all the time saying this one word, which is called as Tathastu. And, you know, if you say you can or if you say you can't, both ways it will say Tathastu and things fall in place. So that's who I am. That's how I am into this trainings and coaching business. So I have answered that question of yours.
But the other question which I ask is, why people need coaches for anything in life, whether it's for health and wellness, whether it's for relationships, whether it's for money management, whether it's for business, whatever it is. Why do you think, according to you, what is the importance of a coach in somebody's life?
Okay, wonderful. Thank you so much. That's a very interesting question. And what I have realized, I've observed something which I learned from a gentleman called T. Harv Eker. He's a brilliant, brilliant coach. And from him, I learned, you know, entrepreneurs are all the time, they're working in the business, be it entrepreneurs, be it job owners, or be it even people who are retired people. And everyone I see, they are all the time, they're working in it. And when you're working in it, you can't see what is happening around you. But the moment you start working on the business, or the moment you start looking at it from a bird's eye perspective, things change. And when you are inside it, you are not able to do that. A coach or a mentor who is standing at a distance is able to observe things for you. And, you know, it is like he can tell you the next step. Okay, this is the next step. Because he's able to see from a distance. What happens when you are there, you are blinded with all the things that are happening around you. A lot of times I've seen entrepreneurs, they are in that, firefighter mode. And they are just, diffusing fire here, fire there. But they don't know if they just run in this one direction straight, there is no fire after that. But that's something that a coach at a distance is able to see. And that's why I think it's made a big difference to me. My coach, Murali Sundaram, I really thank him for being the guiding force who has been able to see through. In fact, if can I add one quick thing, what made a big difference to me because of my coach? Yeah. So during this lockdown time, I used to do a lot of trainings, but pre-lockdown, it was a whole different scenario. And when I used to do trainings, I used to do them in a certain way. But people used to be hooked. All of that was happening. But immediately after the lockdown, I was not able to make those conversions. I was not able to actually get people to the next level. And I ran my course through Murali sir, and I told him, sir, this is what I'm doing. And he pointed just one thing there. He said, Kedar, what are the challenges that people are facing? You're not highlighting them clearly in the course. And it was just one difference. I just inserted that one thing there, and it has made a world of difference. I mean, past 4 months, I don't know how many, if I just think about it, in the last 6 months itself, I've trained and coached over 5,000 entrepreneurs in variety of capacities. So this has opened up, that is what a coach can do. They can just, tap at the right place and things just open up. So that's the importance of a coach. I have multiple coaches, trust me. So I have coaches for a variety of things and I keep taking training. So yeah.
Absolutely true. Even the small things which they say, sometimes even that small thing, which is a normal thing, which we heard many times at that context when they say that, and it really matters a lot, and we take action immediately and everything changes around us. And I've experienced that in multiple times in my life. Thank you for that nice, fantastic explanation. Now, I just wanted to ask, since you are into so many businesses, already you did 2 businesses and now you're in the training and coaching businesses, what kind of challenges you faced in all these businesses and how you overcome those challenges? Because since a lot of aspiring entrepreneurs watching these episode of Startup Stories, I want to mention few challenges and how you overcome that so that they can initially, they can quickly overcome the challenge instead of allowing it to grow to a big challenge itself. Please.
Okay, so thank you for that question. One thing which I would say is, this is something that I learned from Simon Sinek. At the moment you have your, the core right, if you have the why, if you know why you're doing what you're doing, things will fall in place. Yeah. So you have to start with your why. You should be very clear as to why you're doing whatever that you're doing. A lot of times entrepreneurs jump into the arena saying, okay, maybe, if I sell this to something, if I able to trade this, if I able to give this service, I might make some money. But if you're in it to just make some money, all your life you'll be making some money. That's it. You'll be just making some money. But the moment you come with a mindset that I want to add value, and add value by doing, something like this, because this is what I am good at. This is what, when I do this, I am happy. Then the business, which you are setting up is also a happy business. When you are happy doing at what you are doing, automatically the business also gets a happier place to be in. So just dig deeper. What is your passion? What is your calling? It took me almost 5 years to actually realize my passion, my calling. Do not give up on yourself. Keep. There are sometimes people say, oh, I have not found my calling. It's okay. Keep doing. Keep trying. There will be something that will click. You will understand. And the moment you understand, just leave everything and just go behind it. Just go for it. So, starting something which obviously, yes, interior design projects, I love doing that. When the project gets published, it's amazing. It's a wonderful feeling. But there is my logical mind at work. So I know 2 + 2 = 4 and how to make that 2 + 2 = 4 and how to get the project done. It's a learned skill that I have. But when it comes to trainings and coachings, yes, it's a learned skill beyond our level, but something which has also come to me very naturally. This is something back to my college days when I used to do presentations. I used to have people coming from different classrooms to watch my presentation. I never thought of that. That could be something that could be helped, you know, helpful to me in the long run. So that is something. And then, yes, when you realize what's your skill, that's not it. If I had realized only this is my skill and I would have played it in that level, I would have been stuck. But I went and I took training and coaching from the best in the world to take my skills from X level to the world class level. So that is a big gap. I learned from a gentleman called Blair Singer. Thanks to Success Gyan, they got him to India and I got to do the train the trainer under Blair Singer. A wonderful gentleman. I'm sure you have, what Blair Singer can make a difference. And I got to learn from him. And the skills, if I say I was doing BNI trainings, I was doing BNI trainings had given me a platform, but I was at a certain level. The TTT of Blair Singer took me to a completely, I mean, people who saw me also, they said, my God, there is, but this will happen if you believe that there is more to learn. So every time, okay, even if you're an entrepreneur, if you have this mindset of continuous learning and upgrading, you will never be obsolete, because that is the key, you know, in continuously, there is so many things that are happening around us. So as an entrepreneur, you need to be continuously learning, continuously be growing yourself. If you're able to upgrade your skills, I mean, people will come to you provided you keep upgrading. So those are the roadblocks that keep coming and you can overcome them.
Super. And Kedar, you are a marketing habits coach. You teach a lot of marketing habits to people. Now I want to ask you, we are in COVID and post-COVID in marketing, if businesses have to focus on this one thing or two or three, whatever it is, what should be a focus or what should be changed post-COVID for businesses to do the right marketing and to get the right leads and to grow their business? What is that one thing they have to focus on, two or three, whatever it is, post-COVID specifically?
Okay, so thank you so much, Guna, for that question. So post-COVID, my personal belief, okay, so COVID is a situation that has happened. Okay, so a lot of times I've seen people, oh my God, it's COVID, and you know, the business. It's a situation, it's a roadblock, it's a hurdle, which you need to overcome. And, you know, this too shall pass. So that is something that a mindset. So my recommendation is hold on to your core values as to what is your core. If your core is to add value to customers, whatever you're doing, if you're able to add value to your customers, customers will come to you because you are adding value to them. So post-COVID, just find ways of adding value. And as a marketing habits expert, I would tell this. This is something that I have learned at one of the trainings that I train and coach, and the content I got it from there. It is not enough to be the best. Okay, if you could be the best in adding value, so it is not enough to be the best. You should be seen as the best. The moment you are seen as the best, and that is what marketing can do for you. Okay, till the time you are the best, obviously first step is you give value. You give value, you give crazy value, but it's not enough that you just keep giving crazy value. You be seen as giving a lot of value. And when people see this, when people talk about that, okay, he's the one who's giving so much of value, people will come to you rather than you going to customers. So this will happen. So, you know, for which you need to be doing marketing. And analogy of marketing, which I all the time keep saying, you know, to keep your body fit, what do you do, Guna? What do you do for keeping your body fit?
I do badminton and I take care of the food which I intake. These are
absolutely. These are the two things. So badminton is one of an activity which you do. It's a health activity. There are some people who do jogging, some people who do gymming, all of that. So if you do a particular activity and you need to do it on a regular basis, you can't play badminton once and then after 2 months and you play it and will you be fit? No, absolutely not. So you need to do it on a regular basis, So to keep your body fit on a regular basis, you need to exercise. Same way to keep your business fit, you need to on a regular basis do marketing. So that's exactly, you know, something which I tell people. So that is where I get people into a habit of marketing. It's not, you know, a one-time thing. I have seen entrepreneurs, they do marketing, they get customers, and then they are serving those customers. They're serving, and then they realize, oh, now I have to do the billing and admin work. They go and do their billing, admin work, and they're like, oh my God, where are customers? They again go back, start marketing, and they are in this cycle. So if you have a regular marketing habit, you will have regular flow of customers. It's as simple as that. So post-COVID, if you want, or even now, I won't say post-COVID, start it right now. The moment you're listening to this, start into getting into a habit of marketing every single day. Do at least, you know, one bit of activity. There are tons of activities. I'm sure Guna is a super coach. You can come to him. He will give you multiple ideas. You know, go to him, learn from him, and just implement whatever marketing strategies he's teaching you so that you can attract a lot of customers for yourself. So I think, Guna, that is one thing which I would tell everyday marketing.
Thank you. Thank you for that nice tip to everyone. So now, as I already told you, I have a lot of aspiring entrepreneurs watching this, and especially I have hundreds of students inside my startup university where I'm handholding them to start a business. They are not actually an entrepreneur by family or by nature. So they wanted to start a business and they joined me in my startup university. They are taking the course and they are actually learning and building their business right now. So what I want you to do is, since you are into business for more than 10 years now, I want you to give some tips or suggestions on what they should keep in mind while starting this business, or what is that tip you will give to all aspiring entrepreneurs who want to start a business?
Okay. One thing which I would love to tell, and any session also, if I have to do a one-to-one with anybody, I always start with the end in the mind. What's the goal? What's the outcome? What are you looking at? You know, and come with as specific as possible with the outcome. A lot of times people say, I want more money. Then I say, okay, here is 1,000 rupees. Are you happy? Like, no, that's not. So then come up with a specific outcome. If you're deciding to start up on your business, what is the outcome that you're expecting? First, outcome. And without outcome, nothing is going to happen. If you have an outcome, then you have something to look up to, something to reach. Even if you use Google Maps, the first thing that Google Map asks you, if you want to go anywhere, what's your destination? Without that Google Map, some people say, no, my phone asks me, you know, doesn't ask me that, you know, it asks me where I am. I said, yeah, that is what Google has to take as a starting point. But that is what you know. But, you know, obviously you need to start with the end in mind. If you are able to begin with end in mind, I think that's something very, very critical. That's point number one. Point number two is, if you want that end in mind, think about why you want it. It's why you want it. There's something that I learned from Tony Robbins. He says a concept called as RPM. Anything that you do in life, you should use RPM. So R stands for result. You should have, what is the result, outcome. P stands for purpose. What is your purpose? Why do you want it? Because a result without a purpose, you might not be able. You know, you need to have a purpose which will make you jump out of the bed and do those things to reach that goal, come what may. You will be driven only and only if you have a right purpose. So result, purpose, and M stands for a massive action plan. You need to have a massive action plan. I'm again repeating, it has to be a massive action plan. It cannot be just a plan. Okay, it has to be a massive action plan. If you have these three things in place, I mean, trust me, you can achieve whatever that you want. So just follow this concepts. And I think, Guna, you are doing a super job in already handholding people who have, I mean, you know, people look up to somebody. Because when I started, I 2011, I started, and I hired a coach at 2014 after, you know, failing miserably, losing a lot of money. I mean, feeling that frustration. All of those 3 years could have been saved if day one I had a coach. Like I went in 2014, I started, you know, getting a coach on board. And since then, I have never left my coach. So I have my coaches with me. They train me, they guide me. And I have my heartfelt gratitude to them. So thank you to every single of them. One of them who's, you know, contributed in me being who I am. So yeah, that's what I would love to say.
Yes, Kedar, well said. Because we always have this gratitude for all the coaches. But I always feel that the gratitude they will be happy about it. When we inspire more lives, they will be more than happy about it. So that's the
absolutely
which we can give to our coaches by inspiring more and more people, and in turn they will go and inspire again somebody else. So
oh yeah, oh yes, I completely
all the way. And I think this interview, this episode of Startup Stories have created that ripple effect already. And in every episode, that's what I wanted to create. And so thank you very much for sharing a lot of things from your journey. I asked some different questions and you were on the extempore, and I can see that high energy flowing from that inside. And absolutely from a different industry, you came into training and coaching, and you're inspiring a lot of lives right now. And marketing, which is a key part in any business, and you're helping them to make marketing as an habit, which is definitely a mandatory thing for any entrepreneur. So those entrepreneurs who are watching, if you're looking at developing some marketing habits, Kedar Bol is the person to go. And so thank you very much, Kedar, for joining for this episode of Startup Stories.
Thank you so much, Guna. It's my pleasure and honor to be on your show. The book which you have written, it has been published, and at the opening, it was Jack Canfield was the guy who published your book. I mean, he is a fantastic, inspiration to me. And so it takes you, in front of my eyes in a whole different league. Okay. And it's not just because he's done that. I have trained and coached with Guna at All India level. Me and Guna train for BNI at All India level as a co-trainer also. He's so humble, so understanding, and he's the right person to actually help you, kickstart your business. So if you're looking for somebody for that, I think he's the man. Go to him. Thank you so much, Guna, for inviting me here. Yeah, it's been a pleasure doing this interview with you.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for watching this episode of Startup Stories. Do share this video so that you can reach it to as many aspiring entrepreneurs as possible, and definitely they can also take a lot of insights from this particular episode of Startup Stories. So I will see you in the next episode of Startup Stories with one another successful entrepreneur soon. So thank you very much. See you soon. Bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.